week. You're all grown up, Miss America. Guess what, Mom? All of a sudden, it feels like I never was away. I'm hungry. Wait a minute. Better stash this in my room. Just so Mrs. Fitcher knows the Army's good for something. I never got over you complaining about those, what do you call them, slovenly habits.
How did you know me? I never saw that boy in my life.
Now wait one minute. You come back here.
Ma'am.
Well, we can't just let him.
Look. So it wouldn't fall off your finger all the time. about how I was spoiled again.
Who is he?
Here, I'll put it back for you.
No, where's Larry?
Did you say?
Won't someone tell me what's happened?
I see now. That's why you're acting so. It's a nice diamond, Grace. Who? Bud Merkel?
How did you know that?
Because it had to be him. Bud's a nice guy. That should keep the ring.
Why don't you turn it back?
It makes me feel better for keeping it. You know, Mom, I kept telling myself she'd be waiting, but I guess I do.
I'm going to ask her something, and I want you to answer me.
Sure, Mom.
I came in here a minute ago. You look at that picture.
Now,
what do you want, Minnie?
That's a fine question for a businesswoman to ask. shop. Remember what I was saying today?
Yes, I remember, but I really can't think about that now.
There's going to be a vacant store on London Street. That import shop, you know? The one with the ridiculous prices for a plain glass pitcher just because it wasn't made over here. They're going out of business.
I'll take it out, Mom.
It would be a good location, and you should think about it. Freya! Who is he?
I don't know.
He simply couldn't stand thinking about what he must be going through. Frankly, that's the real reason I came over.
I thought it was.
You shouldn't have to deal with a situation like this. Haven't you found out anything?
Either way, yes.
I hope you know you can count on me if you have any emergency. What have you found out?
The dress was $9, Nettie.
Well, of course. Don't want me asking any more questions. I think you're being a very foolish woman. What's the use of having friends? Can't talk to them. Oh, my. He brought the wrong coding purse. The one that's full of soap coupons. How could I do anything like that?
It's all right. Pay me another time.
That's not business. Like, I'll go back to the house.
It's all right, Nettie.
Well, you insist. You really can't do something about fullness and better.
I'm sure that I can.
Well, good night.
Good night.
Mom, since when have you been sewing for the neighbors?
Why are you asking me that?
This stuff behind the screen, isn't that what it means?
Yes.
Why?
I have to.
Mom, there must be a pretty good reason.
Why do you call me Mom?
Why do I call you Mom? All my life, that's what I called you. 21 years.
Who are you? How do you know the things you know about us? You have to answer me because I'm not able to ask you very many questions. I stood at the door of his house tonight waiting for my son to come home and he never got here.
What are you saying?
It's a very hard thing to stand there, then. Who are you?
I'm Larry Benson.
No.
And I'm back in my own home and everybody, and it's coming down my head.
Oh, no, no.
I took a walk. I had to get out of the house. So I walked around the block. There's an apple tree down the street Larry used to buy. It's gone. It's been cut down. I'm not going to fool around anymore. Where do you think you're going? Come back here!
Sam, don't.
What's the matter with you?
Sammy, please, he's frightened.
Do you think I care if he's frightened? He better be!
Larry used to do that. He used to go upstairs to his room when he was frightened or upset about something.
And what difference does that make? Can you just answer that question?
No, I can't.
I'm going in there.
To do what?
I don't know. I'll tear it out of him somehow.
Don't.
What do you mean, don't?
Not now.
Freya, you're beginning to act as if he belonged here. We don't even know him. He's a stranger and he's in Larry's room!
What about you? You're a stranger in this room.
How can you think about that now? For the love of heaven, Freya, where's Larry? Think about that. Where's our son?
I think about that.
How does Ford get here? How does he know the things he knows about us? There are questions to be asked.
I don't think he'll answer you.
He'll answer.
Sam, I don't think he knows.
He knows he's got to. You don't think? Listen to me. That boy knows he isn't there, Benson. That's one thing you can be sure of.
I'm not sure of anything now.
And you can bet that's not all he knows. It might be a dangerous, some kind of spy.
You don't. That?
It's something we should think about.
What are you doing?
The best I can to find out.
It's what any boy would have in his pockets.
I don't care. I'm going to take him by the throat, and I'm going to throw him out of this house.
Did you see his face, Sam? The way he moved around this room, it was just like
Why do you feel anything?
Besides,
I felt everyone staring at me when he walked in here and threw his arms at me. I felt like falling through the floor, and I felt like crying for myself. No, I tell you, I'm going up there, Ben.
No!
You're not going to stop me, Brady.
I am going to stop you. You have no rights in this house anymore.
Get out of my way.
You're not going up there, Sam. Sam, go!
Stop me!
He hasn't done anything to you!
Keep your hands off my mother!
My father.
So,
my
mother.
Come on.
You say that more.
I don't know if anyone's. day he left here. I thought they were mad at me for forgetting to do something I was supposed to do. I thought it was my fault.
The day he left here.
Dad?
Dad's here in the house.
No, I told you. He doesn't live here anymore. He hasn't for over a year.
No.
I haven't even spoken to him.
What are you saying? What are you talking about? You must be making it up. He didn't leave here. He didn't. I've got a family here.
Slipping out of my head. I can't think.
Well, like sweet tea.
No, no thanks. You know, the only thing I could think of, I'm going to call up the army.
Someday.
I'm going to call them up on the phone. The Pentagon, Washington, D.C. They've got every record, every fingerprint down on paper in order, the way they're supposed to. That is an amazing thing. You've got a big machine. They just press some buttons and the whole thing starts moving up and down all by itself. And some cards fall out. The right cards fall out. Larry's name is in that machine. I thought it last night.
It's Sunday.
So what? It's Sunday. What do you think? Shut the whole army down on Sunday? Ask me. Some place. That's what telephones are for. How long do you think I can stand it? So it's Sunday. What should we do? Go to church?
Got to take you a burn tree.
I don't understand you.
I know.
What are you thinking about?
Like I know him.
What?
You're the only one who didn't get any sleep last night. You came into my room last night and I was crying. I must have waited for Mom. He put his hand on my head and I felt it was Larry's hand. I couldn't cry anymore. That's insane, isn't it?
I don't know what's insane. What is it?
Don't call today. Please, not today.
Fred, I feel like I'm walking around inside a vacuum. I keep asking myself questions. Normally, maybe, like a child.
The boy is sick, Sam.
So what if he's sick? Let's get him in here. Find out how he knows this. Where is he?
Upstairs in his room.
Fred, for the love of heaven, it is not his room! I've got some questions to ask you.
I thought it'd be my life's in coffee.
Where do you think you're going?
We're going outside into the yard.
It's like talking to a rock.
The coffee's full of drinks, and I'm all heated up.
My coffee's? That's a beautiful thing to say at a time like this. What are you going to do next? Ask me what the weather's going to be like?
Lying outside in the grass beside the elm tree. Sam, what are you doing? Sam, don't. That doesn't belong to you.
Larry. Look, it's Larry. Where is he?
What are you going to do?
What do you think I'm going to do?
Sam, don't. Let me talk to him, please. I know how.
I know how, too. He had Larry's picture in his bag, and he never opens his mouth.
He couldn't. Can't you understand that, Sam? You can't shout at this boy. He won't hear you.
Well, when he comes back, ask him about the picture. Ask him about Larry's picture.
He's coming back into the house. I will talk to him, and I will ask him about the picture, but I'm not sure.
See.
I can't explain it. I just know it's better that way. Don't want to change your mind about coffee, do you? Grass is doing pretty well out in the back. I don't get out there as much as I should. I used to like to lie in the grass and read. You see, sometimes I'd fall asleep. The hedges are a little worn down, though. You have to take care.
Why did Dad leave here?
I don't think you should talk about that now.
I want to know.
I don't think I can answer you.
He doesn't have the right.
We can't talk about right or wrong of it. Sometimes things just happen and no one knows why. You can love someone very much.
25 years.
Quiet. I always feel like
you.
Peaceful, quiet.
Say Lair. Say Suck. Say Dear. Why don't you call me something?
Take care of hands here.
Mom.
Who is this?
That's Danny. My friend, I wrote to you about him so many times. Don't you remember?
Yes, I remember.
There are so many things about Danny Holmes that are really remarkable. You know, like the harmonica. I told you about the harmonica, how he used to play it everywhere around camp. It was a good sound. Her lieutenant never used to shut him up because the guys liked it so much. I told you.
Yes, you told me.
Danny Holmes, he was my brother. Now, does that sound crazy?
No.
It's how I felt. I really felt like he was my brother. On the ship going over here, we got seasick together. Danny was real sick. I used to swipe tea bags and make tea with hot tap water, and we talked.
What did you talk about?
Home. He only wanted to talk about home. Then when we were feeling better, he tried to teach me how to play the harmonica. I couldn't learn it. You know, he practically toned down. He was a real genius at it. Not since he was a little kid, about six, I think. His folks died. I don't know very much about it. He didn't talk about it very much. He bummed around, I think. Maybe that's why he liked to hear about our home so much. You know, about you and Dad, Jess, and everything. One time we were riding down the dirt road together, really chewing dust. So I told him about the time we took a hayride down to Cat's Creek. It was fun. Remember it? The truck reminded me of it, the bumpiness and everything. So I told it to him. He cried. All the guys looked up at him. Then he told me he never went on a hayride.
What else did you tell him?
Everything. Everything I could think of. What it was like to be a family. The things we did together. How we loved each other. Mom. Should have seen his face when I tell him about our house and show him pictures of us and my school pictures and everything. He'd listen and he'd smile, but somehow he was far away. We could be sitting in a mud hole and he wouldn't even know it was wet.
I don't feel like that.
You know, he never got tired of us. He'd ask me to tell it to him again and again. About our house, our town, all the people we knew. About our lives. About all the stuff he never had. When we got lost that one time, we had to hide in a little cave for 9 days. It smelled like earth from there. It was so small we could hardly move. We'd lie there, and I'd tell Danny about the way we lived for hours. We both forget about being hungry and scared that way. It's funny. That's the happiest I ever saw Danny, those 9 days. It's like when he listened to me. Finally belong somewhere.
Where is Danny now?
Somewhere. I don't think I could ever find it. It's a valley between two hills. Died in my arms there. I don't remember it so well. I started to dig up the ground with my hands and it started to rain, so I wandered back into the mountains. It was like I died, not Danny. It's about me. And I don't know when. It was a long time. They said I was hysterical. I had the pictures in my pocket. That's all I had. He was my brother.
Something in his mind.
What are you doing here?
What am I doing here?
That's what I asked.
Well, Mr. Benson, I know you have the right to ask that sort of thing. But Freya wants a dressmaking business. Yes, you didn't know it.
I know.
In fact, I'm trying to persuade her to get into this in a much bigger sense. And I'm also one of her customers, Mr. Benson.
Something. Stores are closed. They close something too.
Well, I want the first place. Special trip to pay you for the dress. Unless Mr. Benson objects to that. Here we are. Five. It's nine, isn't it? Five, six, seven, eight, nine. And you won't forget about the alterations.
Thank you.